In this video, we'll go over all the WoW news from the past week and try to compress it into a bite-sized video. The weekly event for this week is Bonus Battlegrounds, which is great for people still trying to farm out the PvP essence. The Archaeology Biweekly is the whole reason I still tell you about the Archaeology Biweekly, and it's for the Moose Mount. So, for the next 2 weeks, if you still haven't gotten your Legion Artifact Moose Mount, now is the time to go do it. In order to do the Moose Mount, all you have to do is just go to the Archaeology Trainer in Legion Dalaran, accept the quest, and do it, and you'll get it. You don't actually need to have a high skill in Archaeology in order to do it. The Mythic Plus 8 fixes for this week are Bursting, Tyrannical, and Necrotic. There's going to be a micro holiday on Thursday called Free T-Shirt Day, which is a brand new one, so we don't actually know what this is going to be about. But based on its description, it says there's going to be several vendors throughout Azeroth selling free T-shirts, as well as vendors in major cities selling other kinds of secondary T-shirts. Yesterday, they opened up the ability to reserve your name in WoW Classic. In order to reserve your name, you have to download WoW Classic, go into it and just pick whichever server you want, and then create your character like you would normally. Except, once you create the character, you can't actually play on it. It's just there waiting for you when Classic launches. You can reserve up to 3 names in this way. Patch 8.2 class tuning with today's reset. Frost, Unholy, Destruction, and Arms are all getting a 5% damage buff to all of their abilities. Outlaw Rogues are getting a nerf to their cleave damage, and Resto Shamans are getting an overall buff to a lot of their healing abilities. And now, on to some miscellaneous things. Blizzard added a forum to find old friends for Classic WoW. I'll have a link to it in the video description. Basically, they want to know your character's name, race, and class, the name of the original guild on your realm, and the characters and names of other players you're hoping to reconnect with. Blizzard decided to add RP PvP servers to Classic WoW after a lot of people asking for one. Basically, the difference between an RP PvP server and an RP server and regular PvP servers is that RP PvP servers are basically just PvP servers, but with a lot more moderation, which is what people like. And finally, the Eternal Palace Wing 3 of LFR opens up today, so you can now complete the entire raid in LFR. And now on to the weather report with DevBot the WeatherBot. How's the weather out there?
Make sure to never set small obtainable goals leading up to a big one, because that might accidentally give you motivation to finish.
That's good to know, DevBot. At least it finally stopped raining. Channel update. I should probably let you guys know I'm not stopping these things. There might have been a little bit of confusion based on the last one. Sure, this series doesn't do well, but that was the whole reason I moved it to its own channel in the first place. Like, the whole reason this channel exists is because the series doesn't do well, and I gave up on trying to make it do better. So I'm not quitting it. I did it for 50 more episodes after I finally deemed it a failure of a series, so I'm obviously not gonna stop it now. The numbers are within what I was expecting. Like, I've done YouTube for a long time. I have 2 successful channels. I know what does well, and I'm purposefully not doing those things with this series because I don't care. So, don't worry about it. It's going to continue until I get bored of it, and I kind of like doing it for some reason. So, with that, I'll see you all next week.